I want to show a demo of the Vercel bisect command that can be used in the CLI to help you easily understand when a regression was introduced into your Vercel project. To demonstrate, I've created a basic HTML document and deployed it to Vercel, including some paragraphs of text and some headings. Now, if you look at the Vercel dashboard, you can see a series of deployments I've made to simulate multiple people working on this project. Now, at some point in the lifecycle of this project, a regression was introduced to add a paragraph here that looks like it accidentally added a P character instead of a P tag. Let's use Vercel bisect to understand where this regression was introduced. Inside the terminal, we can run Vercel bisect, which will ask us to introduce the URL where the bug occurs. Let's enter in our live production site. Next, it will ask us to enter in a URL where we don't see the bug. To find this, we can go back over to our deployments tab. And for example, we could start with one of the earliest deployments. If we go out and visit this URL, we can see that there's no error here. So let's take this and go back to our terminal and paste it in. Now the subpath where this occurs is just our index route. And now it shows that we have 5 deployments left to understand where this regression was introduced. So let's check this first one. It looks like everything is fine here, so I will use G to say it's good. I can also press enter to see what these options are. So we'll answer G, we're on the next one. In this one, we do see the regression, so we're gonna mark this one as bad. And just like that, the Vercel CLI can tell me that the first bad deployment here was this specific URL. This is when the regression was introduced. Comparing the URL in the terminal with our list of deployments in the dashboard shows that this is the deployment where the regression was introduced. So if we wanted, we could instantly roll back to the last working production deployment. So let's go over to the terminal and we can run Vercel alias, followed by the last working URL from our list of deployments, and finally the production domain we want to alias it to. Now, if we go back over to our live URL and we refresh, we'll see that we've rolled back instantly to the previous version of our site that didn't have the regression. And if we go back to the dashboard, we see that it automatically updates to show this version is now the current production version.